Developments tonight as the plot thickens in that case against the pet shop owner charged with animal cruelty. 7 Action News reporter Andy Choi is live in Warren tonight after learning more about the history of this case. And Andy, it sounds like this goes way beyond allegations of just mistreating animals.
That's right, Carolyn, and we want to tell you just moments ago, the owner of Greenwood Pet and Plants, Dennis Jones, actually drove up to the entrance of the pet shop here, stayed here for maybe 10 seconds tops, and then just drove away. You know, when the raid occurred yesterday, we were all under the impression that it was animal cruelty as the main motivator. We have since learned debt collection may be the real reason behind the raid. 37th District Court Officer Paul Zielinski has been busy attempting to sell the pet store's fish to other local pet suppliers, all to fulfill this court order to collect $2,200 from Dennis Jones. The sign on the pet shop door shows Jones also owes back taxes.
Those fish, the valuable ones, were the nugget. They were the ones that were going to make this sale worthwhile. The rest of the fish were going to go with them.
On top of that, Zielinski says while he was away on other business this afternoon, someone entered the store and took several hundred dollars in exotic fish, a big reason why most local pet stores are passing up on what's left of the inventory.
It was unsettling, yeah. But Dennis is out of jail. That's the main thing.
Jones's mother says with her son now out of jail, she hopes he can salvage some part of the family business her late husband built years ago. Unfortunately, the inventory in the store tonight will not cover the debt, but still court officers say somehow, some way, they will collect from Dennis Jones. Reporting live in Warren, Andy Choi, 7 Action News.
All right, thanks a lot, Andy.